So I'm back again for another visit at Beike's operation here in Thailand for a 25-day visit that centers around 10 stem cell treatments. And in addition to that, we're going to do some programming on the stimulator to be able to hopefully get more activity in my legs. So we'll see how that turns out. But this was part of my plan of a 4-visit plan over a 2-year period, every 6 months. And I've had good progress thus far, and I'm looking forward to continued progress. I arrived here 3 weeks ago, and I have about a week left, about 5 days left. It's like coming back to greet old friends. I mean, everybody was so kind and nice and happy and welcoming when I came back, and they knew exactly what my routine was and what needed to be done, and it's been great. Looking back on my 2 months last year, it's almost like a great adventure, and I don't know if I would have ever gotten anywhere near where I am now without that 2-month commitment. And I think the stem cells were the overwhelming majority of that.
Okay.
Oh. I'll get the bad out of the way. It seems that I have annual UTI infections. I don't know why, but in October, every year now, for 3 years, I've had them. So I spent about 6 weeks in bed and another 3 weeks or so recovering. And it took a lot out of me. But amazingly, during that period, I went to my internist afterwards, and my muscles, I'd actually built muscle mass. And so I was doing minimal exercising, but my arms and shoulders developed muscle mass during that period. So the stem cells apparently kicked in.
I'm going to hit whoop.
They kick in, and the muscles wake up and develop. But it's sort of like they had to be partially awake to start with. And it's actually the spinal cord allowing the signals to go through and say, hey, muscles, you're open for business, not just partially, but you're really open. So that was about 4 months after I left. So I started doing a mile loop around the neighborhood. And I could do maybe a tenth of a mile, and I'd stop, and I'd be huffing and puffing. Well, in 3 weeks, I was able to go from 56 minutes down to 30 minutes and only stop a few times to recover. So my strength, my stamina, energy level all improved dramatically. I mean, that to me was like, I can't believe it.
How long left?
2:15.
How can it be more minutes now than it was?
I felt comfortable in my wheelchair for the first time. It's a weird feeling. I had enough control, and I was solid in it. I was strong enough in it. I had my balance in it. And it was the first time that I ever felt like that. So it's pretty cool.
So left side has always recovered stronger earlier. So I won't give up trying to develop the right. You think something that simple, it wears you out.
My grasping is improved, and I can feel light touch in the stomach and in the back. So it seems like things are slightly moving down and moving this way, and I'm hoping that continues. We'll see.
This one's even more difficult, even though my pinch is better, because my coordination is off. I use more shoulder.
And can pinch.
Better than last time,
summer? Yes, like a big one, and now a little one, he can pinch it.
As far as the journey to independence continues, I still need assistance getting dressed and showered and preparing food, but everything else I can take care of myself during the day. So now I can get into the refrigerator, grab something, and close it up before I almost break a thumb or something trying to get the refrigerator open. Now it just pops open. Getting around the house, I fly around, grab corners of walls and doors and swing around them like it's nothing. So I have much better balance. I'll help set the table. I've even folded towels, you know, in laundry. Transfers are a piece of cake. And when I go to bed at night, I go to bed independently. That's come a long way.
By now, it should be okay.
134 and 75.
Good. Thank you, June. Good. Whoop, thank you.
Before I came back, the stimulator was providing, I'd say, minimal benefit. We only programmed the stimulator to be able to raise a knee. And if I didn't keep up with it every single day with a deliberate routine, then I'd go backwards and have to start all over again. We did some more programming this time, and I'm excited because the programming actually challenges the muscles significantly. And my muscles and my legs are much more pliable and loose. So when he does the leg stretches and stuff, they stretch really well. So instead of having legs that are almost comatose, they're much more like a regular person's legs. So that I'm kind of excited about, as well as the programming to be able to stand. Even in the four times that we've done the standing, my legs have gotten stronger. My left leg can actually extend and straighten and hold my weight. My right one still has a little work to do. So it's a matter of time, practice, muscle development, and then the mind, you know, controlling it. But I feel good that I'll be able to stand. The challenge, being a quadriplegic, is the upper body being able to hold things and control it. So I need somebody to hold me to help. And hopefully over time, that improves and I can hold myself up. It's not that I'm just standing. I mean, I'm working every muscle in my body, including my tongue, which is at the roof of my mouth going, you know, to stay up. So it's a great workout, and hopefully it'll have a payoff.
This knee locked good.
Yes.
And this one almost, for
yeah,
a second.
Almost, yes. But
it hadn't done that well before.
Yes.
So it's getting stronger.
Yes, sure.
My stomach muscles are starting to tighten up again. And so I really don't have the pooch. Same weight, feels good. Feels like I'm getting my body back a little bit. So that was pretty cool.
Good, you look stronger.
Stronger, huh?
Yeah.
One of the things I would love to be able to do is to, with a walker, be able to take some steps, whether that's from the stimulator working, or whether it's from the stem cells kicking in, or however it does. I don't have that as a gotta deliver, but that's a, you know, in the middle of the night, boy, I wish this could happen, kind of a goal. And I feel so much closer to it now because I have the upper body strength now to help stand and to be more solid standing from just moving your leg knees up versus actually standing up without a brace. That's a huge advance. So yes, I feel a lot further along. And I know with this additional stem cells that I'll get additional benefits. I just don't know what they'll be.
The longest.
Yeah.
Beike has the best protocol out there, whether it's the rehabilitative side or the stem cell. There's no one even close on either side. And I talk to people all over the world about stem cells. I've still yet to find anything anywhere near as good as this program. I tell people, you go wherever you want to go, but you're not getting what you need to get. But in some cases, it's cheaper and more convenient. It's probably better than nothing, but not as good as what they could get.
So what, D-Crop?
Oh, squatting up.
Good afternoon.
I look at you, you're all in your work clothes.
Yeah, I'm ready. So you're yeah, ready, right?
I don't want to hurt your hands before surgery.
If I was all alone in the world, could I take care of myself? That's my real goal. And you can see people that work hard actually do improve. They may not improve a tremendous amount, but they improve. And I know that if I work hard, I improve. So it's just taking baby steps and not getting discouraged that you're not there yet. The more I can take a load off of somebody else and take it on myself, that's progress.
It's progressing. Looking good, huh?